Like, what can you say? I mean, shout out to Bo, Mac, and Terrence, man, and that whole team over there in Nebraska. They did a fucking thing.
Is Crawford an all-time great now?
Oh, hell yeah. Well, I've been talking to the same two-time undisputed. That's the question.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, he's great.
What is different about this camp with Jake? You've been in all the camps. He says
It's
better than ever.
We took it back home with this one, man. We took it to the Midwest. You know what I mean? We pulled out our guys at Crump. You know what I mean? And, you know, if you know boxing, then you know Crump. You feel me? So at the end of the day, I'm going to let Jake's performance answer all y'all questions in the time, but at the end of the day, y'all know how we coming. When y'all see that KRONK, y'all know what it is.
You know, Jake said in an interview recently on The Zone that he feels some sort of sense of relief, you know, coming off of his defeat.
Yeah.
You know, it was a very tough fight, very close fight, but he says that since he doesn't feel as if he has to protect that O, he feels more fluid, more elusive in the ring.
A lot of times, man, listen, a loss can make a motherfucker so much better. You know, a lot of these guys trying to hold that O. I try to hold my O as long as I can, you feel me? Hey, look, the higher you get up on that ladder, the harder the fighters get, you know what I mean? So at the end of the day, he got something off his shoulders, he's back, he's better. Everything we need him to be, tune in.
What's the ceiling for him, Jleon?
Ain't no ceiling. That's the same for any of y'all doing this shit. Media, ain't no ceiling. At the end of the day, when there's another young great fighter coming behind the last one, there's more room and more work for y'all. At the end of the day, as long as we working and standing in that gym, the fucking sky's the limit.
You know, you guys added the Hall of Famer Sugar Shane Mosley also in y'all's camp. What do you take away from a fighter and now a trainer? What do you take away when you add another tool to the belt?
Yeah, man. I mean, who the fuck can tell you about anything? A lot of these guys out here that are trainers can't tell you what to do in the 6th round, 8th round, 10th round, 12th round, because they ain't never been there. You feel me? But you got Shane Mosley, who fought the best, been in with the motherfucking best, won and beat the best. At the end of the day, man, it's Shane Mosley. His accolades, his resume, what he's done. If he can give you just a little bit, that helps. So it don't matter.
You know, 2023 has been a hell of a year for the sport of boxing. You know, and it used to be in the past, Jleon, that everybody was always trying to protect their O's. Not too many guys wanted to risk it all for the biscuit. You know, where do you see the landscape as far as boxing here in the near future?
Yeah, listen, man, these motherfuckers are making fights. This year has been the year of all the great fights. And it's happening, and we just want to, I'm grateful. I don't want to ask for too much. I just want to keep this thing, I want to keep it going. We don't want to switch it up. It's moving, so let's get it.
Jleon, let me ask you this, man. I've known you for a long time.
Yeah.
With Steel and everything. How surprised are you, a guy like Jake Paul, Disney kid, YouTube star, coming off the street, and I don't care, these guys are world-class fighters, that if you saw them in the street, you wouldn't mess with them. He's knocking them out after a few years of training.
Man, listen, man. It's crazy. Listen, like, again, the old man in our gym, we had an old man in our gym named Tony that had come in here and beat a young boy ass because he stayed in that gym and he worked. No matter about what you did before, it's what you do when you're in there, when you learn the game. And at the end of the day, man, Jake has learned the game. And so, look, that gives him the confidence. Look, we got Bad Chad Dawson who's been giving us work. You know what I mean? We got some of the best, man. We got Vladimir Shishkin. You feel me? One number one for IBF, Canelo Alvarez. At the end of the day, man, we bring in the best to make our fighter better.
Awesome. Speaking of Canelo Alvarez, obviously he has a big fight upcoming himself with Jermell Charlo.
Yeah, yeah.
How surprised were you knowing that Jermell was the one that was going to step in for his brother?
Hey, man, he's a dog. Jermell is a dog. And that's what it is. He's like, fuck it. He's been wanting a big fight. He's stepping up and doing what he's supposed to do. Shout out to Jermell for keeping the boxing going and making the biggest fights. That's what it is. Shout out to Devin Haney. Shout out to Javante. Shout out to all the motherfuckers. Earl, Terrence. And that's what the game is. Shout out to Shakur. Shout out to all of them young boys, man. They out here doing shit. Look at Devin Haney's resume. Look at that motherfucker. That bitch fighting, man.
Yeah. Well, you know, Devin Haney, they're talking about him and Regis Progress.
Yeah,
that's a hell of a fight.
Go look at that kid's resume. Huh? Say what you want about him. That bitch got a resume. Look at Javante making fights. Hey, whatever. Come on, man. These motherfuckers saving the game. Get these young boys some props.
Well, you know, I remember about a year ago during the Ugas fight, I had a one-on-one with Earl Spence Jr.
Yeah.
And I asked him, Earl, when you look at boxing and you're looking at a lot of these young guys, you know, taking risks, going across the pond, you know, risking it all, you know, taking 80-20 splits, 70-30 splits, to make fights and to fight for legacy.
Yeah.
He said that a lot of these younger fighters can do that because, you know, they can bounce back from a loss. Whereas a lot of guys where they're in their mid-30s, you lose, and it's that uphill battle. How do you see a lot of these future fights? You know, a lot of negotiations are happening within social media. Do you see the Gervonta Davis fighting the Haneys, the Haneys, the Shakurs, the Teofimos, and the...
Of course, 100%. All the names, Teofimos, all of them. I feel like we're going to be able to witness greatness by all of these guys fighting each other. Because they know that, look, that's what they're here for. To make the best fights. Everyone, Teofimo, Gervonta, they only here to make the best fights. You know, before we couldn't get it, but we're getting it now, and we need to be excited and appreciate these young fighters, man. Even the young fighters coming up, the Richardson Hitches, all them young guys, man. These motherfuckers, you know, all these young guys coming up, man. They want these fights. I love it. Look at it. Look at motherfuckers. Keyshawn Davis.
Yeah.
He wants this shit. I love it. I'm a fan of all these young boys. They get all my praise. Every one of them.
What message do you give to Earl the True Spence? What message do you give after a hard victory?
Man, look, you ain't got shit to prove to nobody, bro. You a fucking king. You've been holding it down for years. You done built a legacy, bro. Man, fuck these people. People got all these different jokes and different shit. It ain't nothing like this, bro. Coming from where we all come from in this world of boxing, most come from the bottom. And look at what we did. Packing out Cowboy Stadium. Don't ever forget it. Don't ever forget it. Multiple times. Get that motherfucker just do, man. You feel me? So respect the girl. I love you.
Most definitely, bro. Hey, look, I appreciate your time. Any last shout-outs you want to give?